wisdom to their strength. But I got to know that I maximize mine. I don't want to live and die without knowing I maximize my season. I reigned in my season. I did everything that God wanted me to do. And then I gracefully move out of my season to be able to add my wisdom to another group that's coming up. That's the cycle of life. He raised you up for such a time as this. You can't miss your moment.
Come on.
Go out and be all that God has called you to be. Fulfill the degree that you want to get. Follow your dreams, but more importantly, find out God's purpose for you.
Yes.
We're not just products of our parents' passion, but we're products of the purpose of God.
Amen.
So sometimes when you catch me, Lord, agitated or irritated, pardon me, I don't mean any ill will or any harm. I just know if we mess this up, we may mess up something far more critical than just this piece. That's why I'm so, what am I? I'm so passionate and meticulous about the little things, because the Psalms of Solomon says it's the little boxes
that spoil the vine.
It's the little things that you tolerate in your life that's going to destroy you ultimately. And if you don't tolerate the little things,
yes, sir,
they won't grow up to be big things. If you deal with the acorn, you'll never have to deal with an oak tree. If you take care of the mobile, you'll never have to face a mountain. This is not just about us assembling ourselves here to say we've come, but it's the grab hold of instructions. It's the grab hold of instructions. Go out and shine brighter than you were before you came in. Shine bigger. Flame someone's fire. Flame. Fuel their fire. Fan it. What did I say? Flame someone. Fan their fire. Go out and be someone's wind. Be the beat of the wind. Blow on their flame. Cause others to ignite and become a blaze and fulfill their desires. You're nothing without helping somebody else. And sometimes I can be a little outlandish, and I don't mean anyone any harm. I don't.
All right.
I don't. And sometimes it can appear to be abrasive. I can't stand myself for it sometimes because I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm trying to help you.
Come on, sir.
Well, the scripture says work while it's day. went in this night. No man can work. We have to work when the sun is up. So I charge you by the mercies of God, by the love of God, the sweet communion of Holy Spirit. I charge you by His joy and His love, His tenacity, His grace. I charge you to be all of what God has called you to be, not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. For He has equipped you to be all that He has called and commanded you to be. And I decree that nothing by any means shall stop you.
Thank you, Father.
Shall harm you, shall stand in your way. But by the grace of God, all limits are taken off of you. All limits are removed from you. And that you soar into another dimension that even you will not recognize yourself. And then we'll all together turn and lift our hands towards our God.
Yes,
and
Lord.
Give Him glory and give Him all.